welcome to another edition of Pike Mala Hunters. Today is Redemption Day. I'm going to be heading back to that lake where I had all those misses. So I got some new stuff in my arsenal today. I got some homemade thick fluorocarbon leaders. And I made some smaller rigs. And I think maybe I was kind of calibrating why I lost a lot of those fish last time. Probably a lot of them were smaller and I was kind of fishing for bigger pike there. So, but it is snowing, so I don't know how that's going to affect the fishing, but apparently the barometer says kind of before they kind of bite right before the weather goes kind of crazy, like, you know, like a full moon, weather conditions can kind of affect the bite. But the lake I'm going to, the fishing is pretty consistent. It's like a zero limit, so can't keep nothing. I don't keep fish. I like catch and release. You know, I believe in letting fish go, so then the next day, you know, some dad might be out with his kid and his kid might catch that big fish, you know, that you put back. So I think it's important that we preserve fish and do catch and release. But hey, if the limit's two or three, you want to keep them, you know, you can go right ahead and do that. But yeah, I got my, this coffee does seem bigger. It's an extra large, so good for the long drives down to Vulcan County with the V. And yeah, so I'm also pretty close to 50 subscribers there. So if you guys like this episode, help me out there and bump me up to the 50 mark there. So that'd be pretty cool. It's like kind of been watching the subscriber count there. I was at 49, then a couple of you guys kind of left and some people come back, so I don't know, maybe it was that last video or something like that. But anyways, to the main people who watch me there, DC Outdoors, Tubby Guy Outdoors, My Day Off, Queenstown Kids, you guys are awesome. You guys are my my family, you know. Appreciate your support and I love your guys' stuff, and continue to watch your things because I enjoy it, not just because I want subscribers, but it's nice to have that, you know. Anyways, yeah, thanks for Anytime Fishing Outdoors too. He's pretty cool too. Check out his channel. Likes to bite fish like I do. So anyways, got a long drive here ahead and got some Tim Hortons chili today. Sorry guys, I got no barbecue stuff today, so but maybe this weekend I'm going to be doing a little bit more of that. So I got some good recipes. I got my cooking channel back up and running. I got to work on a couple recipes there, though. It's kind of been struggling there, but yeah, no, thanks for watching and supporting me, and we'll see you out the lake and get our lines in the water there. Hey guys, just got to the lake here. It's the cold really dropped here, and it's a little bit more windy and there's a little bit of snow, but it's looking pretty good. There's nobody out here today, so hopefully I can kick these fish's asses today, because I had my ass handed to me in that one episode when I came out here. But I think I'm prepared with the gear I have today. We'll see. I'm going to get my setup going, show you guys what I'm going to be using, and then we'll get our sticks on the ice there. Hey guys, so both rigs are set up here. I'm going to wait probably about 20 minutes, and a little closer to my tip-ups than last time, so hopefully if something goes off, I'm able to nail the fish there. But yeah, I got them a little bit closer, and smelts I'm using are bit smaller there. It's wind chill went down by like another 10 degrees, so it's real cool. It's like minus 11, but it feels like it's like minus 25 right now. So I got my Rob the Max Store balaclava on here, and just kidding. But yeah, I keep an eye on them from here. I got some Tim Hortons chili, so I'm probably gonna chow down on that if I don't get a bite in 20 minutes. I got one tip up. It's in about 5 feet of water. I thought it was a little bit deeper, so I got it kind of just off some weeds there with the small smelt, and I got one with a bigger smelt in there, but I'm going to move to some bigger baits probably later on if these little guys don't go off. So
I didn't get any hits on the other one with the small smelt there, so I got what's called my these are Gamagatsu hooks. I got a single at the top and I got a treble at the bottom, and I got like 80 pound saltwater leader wire here. So what I'm gonna do is a top hook put through the snout like so, and then the tail end is gonna sit like this. So hopefully, so it's gonna hang suspended like that, so if he takes it, he's probably gonna take it head first, and then hopefully. But I'm setting this tip up a ways away from me just because I haven't had any hits close together. So this rig went off a couple times with the double trebles. What I'm gonna do is I hid the hook kind of, this is my Gamagatsu hook. I'm gonna try this and see if this will hook them. But yeah, no, he's pretty smart there. I think they know people have fished a lot in this area, so I'm gonna kind of leave it like this, and if he takes it, I'm gonna nail him, because I know usually if a tip up's gone off a couple times, it's usually the same pike. So we're gonna try that and see what happens. Towards me. Yeah. And oh guys, he's not a bad one. There we go. Yeah, Gamagatsu. So that slight modification did the trick. So he's not bad, little, probably maybe 4 or 5 pounds. So let's get him back in the hole. Okay, guys, a little rusty on the release there. Hey guys, got one on here. I was putting it down the hole and he fucked it. Little pike. And he's a nice size. I gotta get him back in the water because it's so windy out here. Here, guys. I hooked him in the belly. But, yeah, that's probably a 6 pound pike. There we go. And I just put that smelt on. So, talk about. Hey guys. Fish on, I think. Mr. Fishy wants to do. Yeah, I got him. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. T- Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Well, he's coming pretty easily here. Ask me why. Well, he feels big. Like a fucking tank. Oh, yeah. There he is. And I hope I didn't hook him in the way that's gonna, so I can see something down there. But there he is, there he is. Yeah, I see something. And I don't know. Yeah, I see his head. Now he's in some, oh my goodness. He's just tangled in a shitload of weeds, that's all. Oh, God. Weed monster here. Holy fuck, look at this, guys. Oh, my God. He's fat. He must have been that other fat one that I got. Holy shit. Look at how big he is, guys. Up in my rig here. Holy fuck, does he? Oh shit. Yeah. These Gamagatsu hooks are very, very sharp, and I should probably just. Oh my god. Shit. Sorry. Oh god. Sorry. Okay. Where's the. Oh, there's the single hook. Okay. Oh, there it is. Oh, hey, guys. So, just gonna get him back in the water here. There we go. Oh, and I've never seen that many weeds pulled up.